G'day. You know, Huey Lewis in the News did some iconic tunes, and there's some great sax solos in there as well. And the one I want to talk about in this lesson is the sax solo in Back in Time. So, wow, that's a real flashback, isn't it, from the 80s? But it's a great tune, and it's a really cool solo. It's got that a really meaty kind of 80s rock sax sound. So it's another good one to check out. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to play the solo for you all the way through, and then let's look at it bit by bit and see if we can learn the notes. So this is how it goes. Okay, so that's the solo. It goes into some backing lines behind the vocals after that, but it's the main solo part that I want to look at in this lesson. Okay, so let's get started. It starts up on high E, all the way up like this. Two side keys here, the top one here, okay? And a nice big, fat, growly sax sound. So, once we're on that E, the next notes are C sharp, G sharp, B, C sharp. So it's high E, C sharp, G sharp, B, C sharp. Yeah, and again. Then he goes G natural, F sharp, E, F sharp, C sharp, E, F sharp, G sharp. Okay? So G, G, F, E, G, F sharp, E, F sharp, C sharp, E, F sharp, G sharp. Try that again. One more time. Now these solos are really cool to learn because in them there's loads of little segments or licks that you can take away and practice for yourself and use in other solos, using your own solos. And that's a good one, that one right there. It's just a cool little lick, isn't it? So from the top, it goes up to E, C sharp, D sharp, B, C sharp, and then that lick, G natural, F sharp, E, F sharp, C sharp, E, F sharp, G sharp. Let's try playing that. All right, cool. So the next bit goes from the B, B, C sharp, E, F sharp, G natural, G sharp, B. Now this is a little bit like a blues scale, really, isn't it? B, C sharp, E, F sharp, G, G sharp, B. C sharp, E, F sharp, G natural, G sharp, B. Then he does a little run down to the G natural E. And the next line, I'll play it for you and then we'll look at the notes. Okay, so starting on the B. So it's G, E, G, A, G, A, G, E, G, E, G sharp. So again, starting on the B, run down to the G, then G, E, G, A, G, A, G, E, E, G sharp. Whoa, are you sticking with me? It's tricky, this, isn't it? Okay, so let's go from here. Then runs down to the G, W, G, E, G, A, G, A, G, E, E, G sharp. So let's go from boo da boo boo ba doo ba. And again. let's go from the beginning to that point. Here we go. Alright, cool. Well done. We're halfway through now. So let's look at the second half. I'll play the first phrase of the second half first, and then we'll look at the notes. It goes like this. One more time. Alright. So the notes are high C sharp, B, little bit of a G down to an F sharp, E, ba boo ba boo. C sharp, B, little G to F sharp, E. Yeah? And then after that it goes C sharp, B, G, F sharp, E, F sharp, C sharp, E, G sharp, B, C sharp. Right? So from the beginning of that phrase, C sharp, B, G, F sharp, E, C sharp, B, G natural, F sharp, E, F sharp, C sharp, then E, G sharp, B, C sharp. Alright, one more time. Still with me? Alright, so let's look at the last phrase now. It goes like this. Up now, the last phrase starts on a super high G. Now, if you've not learned how to do those notes yet, there's lots of different ways to play them. Check out the fingering chart. That's the best way to see what all the options are. But for this one, the way I'm playing it is with your front F key and the bottom B flat key down here, and the octave key. So I've got my octave key, my front F key, and this key here. Now to get your high notes out, those altissimo notes, you also need to change the shape of your throat. And that's a whole nother lesson really, we'll talk about that. But really quickly, what you're doing is you're kind of arching the back of your tongue. And just closing off your throat a bit, and it helps to get that note out. This is another fingering for high G. You can go B and G, no A finger, right? Just one and three. And then, and the octave key, and your third finger down here, okay? So one, three, octave key, third finger. Now that's got a different kind of sound, that high G. It's a more of a round kind of sound. But it is a bit more stable. Okay, so have an experiment with that, find which one works for you. So, high G, then it goes E, D, and then it goes A, G. If you're struggling to get the high G out, just play the E with the octave key on. And then the last little bit goes D, 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 and then we've got this tricky little line. And what we're doing for that is B flat, A, G, E, and then A, G, E. So again, B flat, A, G, E, A, G, E. And that's another cool lick that you could take away from the solo. Yeah? So B flat, A, G, E, A, G, E. So, from a high G. Again. last time he plays is the G sharp, and then he goes into playing some little backing lines. So let's try the whole solo from beginning to the end. Okay, you ready? You up for the challenge? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. That's a tricky solo. Grab the music and work through it slowly. That's the best thing I'd recommend. And the other thing is, of course, have a listen to the recording, or grab the recording from iTunes or Spotify or wherever you get it from, and listen really, really closely to the way that it's played in the recording. All the little parts, all the little things, the note endings, the notes, the way they're started, the way he does his glisses up to notes, all those different things. That's what gives it that sound, and that's what we're trying to capture. Good luck with that. Keep practicing. I'll see you on the next lesson.